Bedbugs are parasitic insects of the simicid family that feed exclusively on blood. Cimex lectularis, the common bedbug, is the best known as it prefers to feed on human blood. The name bedbug derives from the preferred habitat of Cimex lectularis, warm houses, and especially nearby or inside of beds and bedding or other sleep areas. Bedbugs are mainly active at night, but are not exclusively nocturnal. They usually feed on their hosts without being noticed. A number of adverse health effects may result from bedbug bites, including skin rashes, psychological effects, the allergic symptoms. They are not known to transmit any pathogens as disease vectors. Certain signs and symptoms suggest the presence of bedbugs, such as finding the insect confirms the diagnosis. Description. Physical description. Adult bedbugs are light brown to reddish brown, flattened, oval shaped, and have no hind wings. The front wings are vestigial and reduced to pad-like structures. Bedbugs have segmented abdomens with microscopic hairs that give them a banded appearance. Adults grow about 4 to 5 millimeters long and 1.5 to 3 millimeters wide. Newly hatched nymphs are translucent, lighter in color, and become browner as they molt and reach maturity. A bedbug of any age that has just consumed a blood meal has a bright red translucent abdomen fading to brown over the next several hours and to opaque black within 2 days as the insect digests its meal. Bedbugs may be mistaken for other insects such as book lice, small cockroaches, or carpet beetles. However, when warm and active, their movements are more ant-like, and like most other true bugs, they emit a characteristic disagreeable odor when crushed. Bedbugs use pheromones and caryomones to communicate regarding nesting locations, feeding, and reproduction. The lifespan of bedbugs varies by species and is also dependent on feeding. Bedbugs can survive a wide range of temperatures and atmospheric compositions. Below 16.1 degrees centigrade, adults enter a semi-hibernation and can survive longer, as they can survive for at least 5 days at minus 10 degrees centigrade, but die after 15 minutes of exposure to minus 32 degrees centigrade. Common commercial and residential freezers reach temperature low enough to kill most life stages of bedbugs, with 95% mortality after 3 days at minus 12 degrees centigrade. They show high desiccation tolerance, surviving low humidity and a 35 to 40 degrees centigrade range even with loss of one-third of body weight. Earlier life stages are more susceptible to drying out than the later ones. The thermal death point for the Cimex lectularis is 45 degrees centigrade. All stages of life are killed by 7 minutes of exposure to 46 degrees centigrade. Bedbugs apparently cannot survive high concentrations of carbon dioxide for very long. Exposure to nearly pure nitrogen atmospheres, however, appears to have relative little effect even after 72 hours. Let us now look at the feeding habits. Bedbugs are obligatory hematophages, that is, blood-sucking insects. Most species feed on humans only when other prey are unavailable. They obtain all the additional moisture they need from the water vapor in the surrounding air. Bedbugs are attracted to their hosts primarily by carbon dioxide, secondarily by warmth, and also by certain chemicals. Bedbugs prefer exposed skin, preferably the face, neck, and arms of a sleeping person. Bedbugs have mouth parts that saw through the skin and inject saliva with anticoagulants and painkillers. Sensitivity of humans varies from extreme allergic reaction to no reaction at all, about 20%. The bite usually produces a swelling with no red spot, but when many bugs feed on a small area, reddish spots may appear after the swelling subsides. Although under certain cool conditions, adult bedbugs can live for over a year without feeding, under typically warm conditions, they try to feed at a 5 to 10 day intervals, and adults can survive for about 5 months without food. Younger instars cannot survive nearly as long, though even the vulnerably newly hatched first instars can survive for weeks without taking a blood meal. DNA from human blood meals can be recovered from bedbugs for up to 90 days, which means they can be used for forensic purposes in identifying on whom the bedbug have fed. The feeding physiology. A bedbug pierces the skin of its host with what is called a stylet fascicle, rostrum or beak. The rostrum is composed of the maxillae and the mandibles, which have been modified into elongated shapes from a basic ancestral style. The right and the left maxillary stylets are connected at their midline, and a section at the center line forms a large food canal and a smaller salivary canal. The entire maxillary and mandibular bundle penetrates the skin. The tips of the right and the left maxillary stylets are not the same. The right is hook-like and curved, and the left is straight. The right and the left mandibular stylets extend along the outer sides of their respective maxillary stylets and do not reach anywhere near the tip of the fused maxillary stylets. The stylets are retained in a groove in the labium, and during feeding they are freed from the groove as the jointed labium is bent or folded out of the way. Its tip never enters the wound. The mandibular stylet tips have small teeth, and through alternately moving the stylets back and forth, the insect cuts a path through the tissue for the maxillary bundle to reach an appropriately sized blood vessel. Pressure from the blood vessel itself fills the insect with blood in 3 to 5 minutes. The bug then withdraws the stylet bundle from the feeding position and retracts it back into the labial groove, folds the entire unit back under the head, and returns to its hiding place. It takes between 5 and 10 minutes for a bedbug to become completely engorged with blood. In all, the insect may spend less than 20 minutes in physical contact with its host and does not try to feed again until it has either completed a molt or, if an adult, has thoroughly digested the meal. Reproduction of bedbugs. All bedbugs mate by traumatic insemination. Female bedbugs possess a reproductive tract that functions during oviposition, but the male does not use this tract for sperm insemination. Instead, the male pierces the female abdomen with its hypodermic genitalia and ejaculates into the body cavity. In all bedbug species except the Primacimix cavernis, sperm are injected into the mesospermalgiae, a component of the spermalgiae, a secondary genital structure that reduces the wounding and immunological costs of traumatic insemination. Injected sperm travel via the hemolymph to sperm storage structures, which are called the seminal conceptacles, with fertilization eventually taking place at the ovaries. Sperm protection. Cimex lectularius males have environmental microbes on their genitals. These microbes damage sperm cells, leaving them unable to fertilize female gametes. Due to these dangerous microbes, male Cimex lectularius have evolved antimicrobial ejaculate substances that prevent sperm damage. When the microbes contact sperm or the male genitals, the bed bugs releases antimicrobial substances. Many species of these microbes live in the bodies of females after mating. The microbes can cause infections in the females. It has been suggested that females receive benefit from the ejaculate. Though the benefits is not direct, females are able to produce more eggs than optimum, increasing the amount of female genes in the gene pool. Egg production. Males fertilize female eggs in two ways, vaginal intercourse and forced copulation, where the male forces himself onto the organ called the ribaga, which is to the right of the fourth apparent sternum. On fertilization, the female's ovaries finish developing, which suggests that the sperm plays a role other than fertilizing the egg. Fertilization also allows for egg production through the corpus elatum. Sperm remains viable in the female's spermatheca, a sperm-carrying sac, for a long period of time as long as body temperature is optimum. The female lays fertilized eggs until she depletes the sperm found in her spermatheca. After the depletion of sperm, she lays a few sterile eggs. The number of eggs a Cymex lactularis females produce does not depend on the sperm she produces, but on the female's nutritional level. Alarm pheromones. In Cymex lactularis, males sometimes mount other males. This is because male sexual interest is directed at any recently fed individual regardless of their sex. Traumatic insemination is the only way for copulation to occur in bed bugs. Females have evolved the spermalgia to protect themselves from wounding and infection. Because males lack this organ, traumatic insemination could leave them injured badly. For this reason, males have evolved alarm pheromones to signal their sex to other males. If a male Cymex lactularis mounts another male, the mounted male releases the pheromone signal and the male on the top stops before insemination. Life stages of bed bugs. Bed bugs have 5 immature nymph life stages and a final sexually mature adult stage. They shed their skins through ecdysis at each stage, discarding their outer shells, which are clear, empty exoskeletons of the bugs themselves. Bed bugs must molt 6 times before becoming fertile adults and must eat a blood meal to complete each molt. Each of the immature stages lasts approximately a week, depending on temperature and the availability of food, and the complete life cycle can be completed in as little as 2 months. Fertilized females with enough food lay 3 to 4 eggs each day continually until the end of their lifespan, about 9 months under warm conditions, possibly generating as many as 500 eggs in this time. Sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism occurs in Cymex lactularis with females larger in size than the males on average. The abdomens of the sexes differ in that the males appear to have pointed abdomens, which is actually the copulatory organ, while females have a more rounded abdomen. Since males are attracted to large body size, any bedbug with a recent blood meal can be seen as a potential mate. Males are generally unable to discriminate between the sexes until after mounting, but before insemination. Host searching in bedbugs. Cymex lactularis only feed every 5 to 7 days, which suggests that they do not spend the majority of their life searching for a host. When a bedbug is starved, it leaves its shelter and searches for a host. If it successfully feeds, it returns to its shelter. If it does not feed, it continues to search for a host. After searching, regardless of whether or not it has eaten, the bed bug returns to the shelter to aggregate before the photophase, period of light during day-night cycle. Rest argues that there are 2 reasons why the Cymex lactularis would return to their shelter and aggregate after feeding. One of the reasons is to find a mate and the other is to find shelter to avoid getting smashed after eating. Aggregation and dispersal behavior in bedbugs. Cymix lectularius aggregates under all life stages and mating conditions. Bedbugs may choose to aggregate because of predation, resistance to desiccation, and more opportunities to find a mate. Airborne pheromones are responsible for aggregations. Another source of aggregation could be the recognition of other Cymix lectularius through mechanoreceptors located on the antennae. Infestation. Bedbug bites. Bedbugs can cause a number of health effects including skin rashes, psychological effects and allergic symptoms. Bedbug bites or cymicosis may lead to a range of skin manifestations from no visible effects to prominent blisters. Diagnosis involves both finding bedbugs and the occurrence of compatible symptoms. Treatment involves the elimination of the insect and measure to help with the symptoms until they resolve. Investigation into potential transmission of HIV, hepatitis B, hepatitis C and hepatitis E have not shown that bedbugs can cause this. However, it might be possible that the arboviruses are transmissible. Causes. Dwellings can become infested with bedbugs in a variety of ways, such as bugs and eggs inadvertently brought in from other infested dwellings on a visiting person's clothing or luggage. It could be through infested items such as furniture, clothing or backpacks which are brought in. It could also be because of nearby dwellings or infested items if easy routes are available to travel. Example, through ducts or false ceilings. It could be through wild animals such as bats or birds that may also harbor bedbugs. People visiting an infested area, that is dwelling, means of transport, entertainment venues or lodging, and carrying bugs to other areas on their clothing, luggage or bodies. Detection of bedbugs. Bedbugs are exclusive and usually nocturnal. Peak activity occurs between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m., which can make their detection difficult. They often lodge in dark crevices and the tiny adhesive eggs can be nested by hundreds in fabric seams. Aside from bite symptoms, signs include fecal spots, small dark sand-like droppings that occur in patches around the and especially beneath the nest. Blood smears on sheets, re-wetted fecal spots smear like fresh blood, and the presence of their empty molted exoskeletons are the ways in which one can detect the presence of a bedbug. What are the signs of infestation? If you noticed itchy areas when you wake and you didn't have those when you went to sleep, you may have bedbugs. Particularly if you have used bed or other used furniture at the time the bite started. Other signs that one could have bed bugs include blood stains on bed sheets or pillows, dark or rusty spots of bed bug excrement on bed sheets and mattresses, bed clothes and walls, bed bug fecal spots, eggshells or shed skins in areas where bed bugs hide, and offensive musty odor. Bed bugs can exist singly but tend to congregate once established. Though strictly parasitic, they spend only a tiny fraction of their life cycles physically attached to hosts. Once a bed bug finishes feeding, it relocates to a place close to a known host, commonly in or near beds or couches in clusters of adults, juveniles and eggs, which is called as harborage areas, to which the insects return after future feedings by following chemical trials. These places can vary greatly in format, including luggage, inside of vehicles, within furniture, among the bedside clutter, or even inside electrical sockets and nearby laptops and computers. Bed bugs may also nest near animals that have nested within a dwelling, such as bats, birds, or rodents. They are also capable of surviving on domestic cats and dogs, though humans are preferred hosts of the Cymex lectularius. Bed bugs can also be detected by their characteristic smell of rotting raspberries. Bed bug detection dogs are trained to pinpoint infestations with a possible accuracy rate of between 11% and 83%. Experiments with high-speed gas chromatography to detect bed bugs are also done. Management of bed bugs. Eradication of bed bugs frequently requires a combination of non-pesticide approaches and the occasional use of pesticides. Mechanical approaches such as vacuuming up the insects and heat treating or wrapping mattresses are effective. A combination of heat and drying treatments is the most effective. An hour of treatment of 45 degrees centigrade or over, or 2 hours at less than minus 17 degrees centigrade kills them. A domestic cloth dryer or steam kills bed bugs. Starving them is difficult as they can survive without eating for 100 to 300 days depending on the temperature. Resistance to pesticides has increasingly become significant over time, and harm to health from their use is also of concern. It has potential toxicity to children exposed to it. The fungus Buvera bacina was being researched for its ability to control bed bugs. Predators. Natural enemies of bed bugs include the masked hunter insect, also known as the masked bed bug hunter. It also includes cockroaches, ants, spiders, mites, and centipedes. Epidemiology of bed bugs. Bed bugs occur around the world. Rates of infestations in developed countries, while decreasing from 1930s to 1980s, have increased dramatically since 1980s. Previously, they were common in the developing world, but rare in the developed world. The increase in the developed world may have been caused by increased international travel, resistance to insecticides, and the use of new pest control methods that do not affect the bed bug. The fall in the bed bug populations after the 1930s in the developed world is believed partly due to the use of DDT to kill cockroaches. The invention of vacuum cleaner and simplification of furniture design may have also played a role. The exact cause of this resurgence remains unclear. It is attributed to greater foreign travel, more frequent exchange of second-hand furnishings among homes, a greater focus on control of other pests, resulting in neglect of bed bug countermeasures and increasing resistance to pesticides. The common bed bug, the Cymex lectularius, is the species best adapted to human environments. It is found in temperate climates throughout the world.